you're a brand new Mac owner, you might have wondered what the little red, yellow, and the green buttons on the top left corner of the screen do. So today in this short tutorial, I will be talking about these three dots. These dots are pretty much on every application or window on a Mac, and I'm just going to go over what they mean. So let's start off with the first one. So just for demonstration, I'm actually going to open up a Safari window. So the first one is the red dot. So on a Mac, the red dot is for closing a window, not quitting the application completely. So if I close this window, notice how on the top left corner it will still say Safari, which means this app is still running in the background and I've only closed the window. When I press the red dot, it will actually close the window, not actually quit the application, and it will be running in the background. Also, as you can see, like, it's a nice animation. When I bring my mouse over the red button, it will actually say cross. So basically in Mac, it says cross means close, because on a window, on a window PC, when you press the cross, the close button, it will actually quit the application, not just close the window. So on a Mac, it closes when I press it. As you can see, it still says Safari. I can access all the Safari options from browsing history, bookmarks, and windows. So it shows me Safari's open. So the only difference between was closing a window and quitting it completely was, right now, as you can see, I close the window, so Safari is still open and I can easily open a new tab by going in File, New Window, or I can also press use one of these shortcuts such as Command N. It opens up a new window, and I can close it back again using pressing the dot, because I opened three times, I have to press it three times. There were three Safari windows. So the red dot usually means close. However, there's an exception in some apps. So one of the app is Photos app of macOS. So if I just open Photos, so if I press the red button, instead of actually just closing the window like it would do on a Safari or any other, for example, Messages, Pages, if I press the dot, it will actually close the window. But on Photos, if I press the dot, it will actually quit the application. So as you can see, now it shows me Finder instead of Photos. So it means that actually the application is closed, it's not running in the background. Now, another way to check that is you can actually head over to your dock and see the photos. There's no small dot below the photo icon. That dot just shows that the application is still running in the background. For example, for my Messages or Pages, I know I have another Pages document open, which is just minimized. So it shows me a dot that it's actually open and running in the background. So if Photos was running in the background, it would have the dot. Like Safari would have the dot because it's running in the background. I didn't actually quit it using Command Q. Now moving on to the next one, this amber yellow dot is minimized. So it's the same as the one you will get on PC. Pressing the yellow or the dash will just minimize the application. So once you hit this button, the window will move down over to your dock in the bottom right corner. And to resume your work, all you have to do is click on the window and you want to reopen, and it will come right back up. For me, it was Safari, so I will just click once and just comes back up. The next one is the green dot. So basically this green dot, or you can also call maximize, has two different functions. So one of which is to go in full screen, or you can also say maximize, as I said before. So all you have to do is click on it and everything melts away, enlarging the window to fill in the screen to view what's on the page. Now to just get out of this, all you have to do is click the escape key, the ESC key that's on the top left key on your keyboard, or also the key that's right beside on the left hand side of the F1 key. So if I press the escape key, it's not maximized anymore. But this method might not always work for some applications, but there's another way. So I will just go back and maximize to show you the other way. So if you press the escape key and it doesn't go out of maximize. So the other way is you take your mouse and go on top of the screen until you see the toolbar, and all you will see the red and the green maximize button. You press the green dot and it will actually go, like, it won't be maximized anymore. Earlier in this video, I said that the green dot also has a second purpose. So now this feature is only available in most recent operating systems for the Mac. So it might or might not work for you. So I just opened Reminders and my calendar, so which are the two most likely apps that I will use side by side. Now to do this, all I have to do is press and hold the green dot and you will see it lights up. If I drag it to the right, it highlights the right, and if I drag it to the left, it highlights the left side of the screen. So now what I'm going to do is to run these applications half screen. I want my calendar to be on the left side, so I will just go on the left side, not on the right side. On the left side, I will leave my mouse, and as you can see, it will melt into the half screen, divide the screen to half, and my calendar app will actually take the left half of the screen. And then if I have more than one application open on the right side, I will actually have the option to choose. For now, I only have one reminder, so I will just go over there and tap and goes full screen. So now it says 50-50, or you can also call it split screen. So now if I'm working on my calendar and I want more space on my calendar side, the left side, not on my reminders, so all I can do that is I can go like in this black vertical bar, I can take my mouse in the middle. As you can see, the cursor will change, and I can press and drag it to the right to increase the size for the on my left side, so for my calendar, or I can also do the vice versa, hold it and drag it to the left to get more side on the right side, like more write up area or view area on the right hand for my reminders than my calendars. Hopefully after watching this video you have an idea of how these three buttons works. Feel free to ask any questions in the comment section below or via email, which is mentioned in the description box below. Make sure to hit that like, subscribe and the share button. Also, while you are at that area, hit the bell icon next to the subscribe button to get notifications over time as we post new videos. Thanks for watching.